company, an online service for lawyers. PLC is the UK's leading provider of legal know-how. We provide practical, up-to-date resources to help you work more effectively and deliver greater value to your clients. My name is Sophie Capel and I'm head of PLC Employment. I joined PLC from Ashurst's and previously worked at Denton Hall in the employment team. Today I'd like to show you how you could use PLC Employment to save you time and reduce the amount of non-chargeable work you do in a day. You have a meeting shortly with a new client who has a possible unfair dismissal and disability discrimination claim. You're aware that the Equality Act 2010 has changed the law on disability discrimination, but you're not sure how. You're also unsure whether claims could be brought under the old legislation or under the new law. How can PLC Employment help? You search Disability Discrimination and Equality Act 2010 on the PLC Employment homepage. Within the search results, you find a practice note, Disability Discrimination under the Equality Act 2010. You scroll down and find a section on types of discrimination. The practice note confirms that there's a new type of disability discrimination. Discrimination arising from a disability. It becomes clear during the meeting that the client has potentially good claims for both unfair dismissal and disability discrimination. You need to draft an ET1 and double check whether the discrimination claim should be brought under the old law or the Equality Act 2010. You find the following useful materials on PLC Employment. A legal update on the commencement and transitional provisions of the Equality Act, which confirms that the disability discrimination claim should be made under the Equality Act, as the potential discrimination took place both before and after the 1st of October 2010. You also find a practice note, Discrimination in Employment, Bringing and Defending Claims, which contains useful sections on how to draft an effective ET1 for discrimination claims and effective litigation tips for employees bringing a discrimination claim. Then you find on site a sample ET1 for disability discrimination and unfair dismissal, which sets out how to plead each type of disability discrimination claim under the Equality Act, with helpful integrated drafting notes linking to other useful PLC materials. Later that day, you get an email from a client. One of his employees is frequently absent for short periods of time. Your client is thinking of dismissing him and has asked you how to do it and the potential liabilities. You'd like to make a list of practical pointers to give you an overview of the issues to discuss with your client. You go to the topic Sickness and Incapacity and click on the Checklists tab. Here you find a useful checklist, Sickness, Absence, Dismissals. It highlights the relevant practical and legal issues. You notice that there's a practice note, Managing Sickness Absence, which explores these issues in more detail. You think the employer should obtain a medical report to try and establish if there's an underlying medical reason for these absences. You know the client will need the employee's consent, but would like assistance on the procedure to follow. You find a practice note obtaining a medical report on an employee on the PLC Employment site, and it contains a box listing the relevant documents that we needed to be drafted in relation to the request for a medical report. If your client subsequently dismisses the employee and you receive a copy of the employee's ET1, you can use the sample ET3 on unfair dismissal, capacity, ill health, draft your client's response. The ET3 is downloadable into Word, where you can then edit the document as you see fit. If, after submitting the ET3, your client decides to settle the claim and you need to draft a compromise agreement, you can use the standard compromise agreement long form, which contains helpful drafting notes and practical negotiating points. You can also draft this agreement using Fast Draft, our automated drafting tool, which allows you to automatically create advanced first drafts in minutes. Your next meeting is with a client whose employer has gone into administration. She's been made redundant and is concerned that she won't receive her unpaid salary or her statutory redundancy payment. How can PLC Employment help? You go to the restructuring and insolvency topic page and find a practice note, overview of the employment aspects of insolvency. This confirms, among other things, the claims that your client is likely to have against the insolvent employer. It also alerts you to the fact that it will not be possible to bring employment proceedings against the employer, as there is a stay of legal proceedings against companies in administration without permission of the administrator or consent of the court. You'd like to find out what other options that there are for your client to claim the amounts owed to her. The same practice note, claiming against an insolvent employer, contains practical tips for claiming in the employer's insolvency and claiming from the National Insurance Fund. Within the practice note is a link to a related checklist, Employment Debts Guaranteed by the National Insurance Fund, which lists the types and amounts of debt that your client will be able to claim from the state. It transpires that your client's employer made collective redundancies without complying with its duty to collectively consult. Your client wants to claim a protective award in the Employment Tribunal. You need to advise her whether it's worth pursuing litigation, assuming that the stay on proceedings can be lifted. You find a helpful list of practical considerations in the practice note claiming against an insolvent employer. Thank you for your time, and I hope this has been of help. Do get in touch if you have any questions. The PLC Employment team are specialists in their field, helping you to work faster and smarter. PLC has over 3,400 subscribing organisations worldwide, including 95% of the UK's 500 largest law firms and 90% of the FTSE 100.